What's up, YouTube? I got one more fishing story for you. I don't know if y'all know what a gar is, but I'm sure most of you do. But anyway, it's a long, skinny fish. You know, they get 3, 4, 5, 6 feet long, and they got this long nose, full of teeth, real narrow, it's like a duck, almost like a swordfish duck bill, Well, one time when I was about, I guess 14, maybe somewhere near 13, 14, 12. All my buddies and we'd swim in the river. And we had this real nice spot, had a bunch of big boulders we could jump off of into the water. And some of the boulders were like maybe a foot underwater. Right on the bank, and then you could jump from there. The water would be 6, 7, 8 feet deep. Well, we were jumping off the rocks, having a good time swimming around, and I looked down at my feet, and there was this gar stuck between two rocks. It wasn't a big gar; it was probably 3 feet long, maybe, and it was still alive. But it couldn't move. It was wedged in between two big rocks. So anyway, I didn't want to pull it out by the mouth. Nobody else did either. But it had its head, I don't know, it was wedged in right in the gills, right past the gills. So we thought we could pull it out, head first. Because if we pulled it from the tail, it would get tighter and tighter. So it went in, I don't know how it got in. It looked like I don't know how it got in there. But anyway, nobody wanted to grab it by the mouth and pull it out. So we just sat there thinking how we can get it and all this stuff. About that time, here comes people down the river on some inner tubes. And they had some rope. And I asked if we could borrow some rope. We got this fish here that we want to pull out of the rocks. And they thought it was crazy. But he gave me a rope and we made a little lasso and hooked it around the fish and pulled it right out. And as I pulled it out, it laid a whole bunch of eggs. I mean, it squeezed the eggs out of it. That's how tight it was. I mean, it's probably 1 million eggs, But the fish was alive. I don't know how many days it had been stuck there, but it'd been a while because its back where it was stuck was kind of bent like an S. And it was like almost like rigor mortis had set in. The fish was kind of crooked there, like a, I don't know, it's weird. It was right behind it, its gills, And the guy that we borrowed the rope on, he was wanting to keep the gar, and I didn't want to keep it. I wanted to throw it away, throw it back in. So anyway, we ended up throwing the gar back in the river, and where it was bent like an S, the gar swam in a circle. It's going all the way down, with the current real slow. So I didn't know if it was going to make it or not because the way, it couldn't straighten itself out. I figured maybe in a few days it might, I don't know, work its rigor mortis out of it. I don't know. But anyway, a couple years later, I went back there and was fishing, and that same gar was going in a circle right there in the same spot where I let it go 2 years prior. But anyway, it's still alive. Thanks for watching.